All right, folks, it's been described as our daily ding-a-ling. I don't know about that, but it is the closing bell report. And joining us now is Rob Williams, Newsmax Deputy Financial Editor. And Rob, let's take a look at the numbers as they go up. A good day for the Dow. It's the 32nd record close of the year, the best day since November 5th. The Dow up 103 points, closing at 17,880. The S&P up 14 points, and the NASDAQ up 20 points as well. So reversal from some of yesterday's numbers.
Yeah, it looks like the Dow is closing in on that psychological level of 18,000 that some people have been hoping for. So we may see that in the
tomorrow.
Yeah,
maybe after hours trading. Who knows? Yeah, that could happen. All right, so we had energy companies, big gainers today. And this is a shift from what we have been talking about.
Yeah, they actually bounced back, and it's interesting because oil prices actually fell again today. They didn't hit that five-year low like they did last week, but they came close. So there's some talk that people were unwinding their short bets on energy companies and coming in and covering those, and that supported the shares.
And there was some data today that came out. Of course, the big data is coming up at the end of the week on November's numbers, but construction spending rose. Was that greater than expected?
It was much better than expected, the best since May, and that helped give stocks a lift. We also got good numbers out of the car makers, like General Motors, especially General Motors. Said that its truck and car sales rose.
Well, that always gets me because, and this is something that the media reluctantly says, and certainly, you don't hear from the left. Obama and those touting the great economy might talk about the increase in car sales. But it is driven by the big cars and by the trucks, usually, when these companies report, more sales.
Yeah, and that is the case this time. The Jeep brands did well in the Ram pickups, and those are gas guzzlers, so it may be a sign that the lower oil prices and lower gasoline prices are encouraging people to trade up for gas guzzling cars and trucks.
Yeah, that's true. Of course, that could turn around. It's a gamble. You talk about gambling on the stock market. That's always a gamble, gambling on gas prices. The national debt. Now over $18 trillion.
That's right. It passed that dismal benchmark last week, it looks like. And so it's up about 70% since President Obama took office.
Oh, don't bring that up. That's not fair. He inherited the greatest financial catastrophe of all time. I'm only kidding.
All right. Well, one year of that was George W. Bush's budget. So
all right, we had numbers for Cyber Monday. Because Black Friday numbers were disappointed, and we talked about this yesterday. It's hard to focus now. A lot of economists want to, expand the whole from now until, after January. But nonetheless, Cyber Monday results way up from a year ago.
Well, they were up by 9%. But a year ago, they were up 20%. From the year before. So it looks like the growth rate is kind of shrinking. It's still headed in the right direction, just at a slower rate.
Well, it's like when they call it a budget cut. A budget cut is a budget cut in Washington if it's only raised 5% in the budget compared to being raised 10% the last budget. They call it a budget cut, but it's still up 5%.
It is.
Yeah, all right, so that's not bad news. We have the unemployment report on Friday, as mentioned, and the European Central Bank last meeting of the year with the decision on QE expected, on Thursday?
They're not expecting a decision on that. They may hold off until next year, but that would be, if we could get any kind of direction indication on whether they're going to start pumping money into the European economy the same way the Fed did the last few years.
Before Thursday. All right, Rob Williams, as always, thank you, sir.
Appreciate it.
And if you want to take control of your financial future, folks, check out moneynews.com. It's live 24/7, and now it's live on your TV screen as well. Also, folks, if you want to be on the show and weigh in on the hot news topics of the day or ask me a hard-hitting question, be sure to go to newsmax.com/Skype and sign up. That's newsmax.com/Skype. You have to sign up. Next, give me five.